We'll be okay. We'll be okay. We'll be okay. We'll be okay. Can you help me with today's poem? I didn't get it at all.
Yeah, dude, it's fine.
Okay, we'll meet by the library around 11.
Alright, yeah. Okay. See you then.
See you then. Okay, I don't get it. Throughout the whole poem, he's just talking about his body.
Well, it's more than that. When you look at how visceral he's being about it, you can guess he's talking about how he feels in the inside.
So, emotions then? Like these lines here, he's just talking about emotions?
Yeah, definitely. Based on that ending right here, it's him going off the edge. And it's definitely coming to be about a guy who was feeling terrible. And then in the end, just gave into it.
Okay, well, that's a little depressing.
I mean, it's not for sure. It really could be anything.
Okay, well, we need to do a little better than I'm not sure, because we have a lot riding on this, and I don't want to fail.
No, don't worry. We'll get this done.
Okay, well, we better, because it's about 40% of our...
I know that! Please let me think!
Hey, David, sorry about earlier. I was just really stressed out. Okay, what were you saying earlier about the guy in the poem?
Wait, what? What are we working on here?
The poem that's due Friday?
Right. Well, this definitely has something to do with a great loss of confidence, and yeah, struggle with motivation as well. Yeah.
Well, didn't you just say there was a guy being depressed and wanting to take his own life?
I did not.
Okay, partner. Well, what do you recommend then?
What?
Okay, well, you know, why don't we just reschedule for tomorrow? I'll meet you here. I'll meet you outside. I'll reserve the study room here. I'll see you tomorrow. Hey, Diego.
Hey, David.
Hey, David, can I ask you something?
Yeah, that's fine.
How many minds do you have in your head?
What?
Like, how many different people do you have inside of you?
What are you talking about?
Like that movie, Split. Have you seen Split? Where they change different personalities? Are you like that?
Do
you
have multiple people? No, we're not like that.
Personalities. No. Okay, so do you have... Okay, do you have someone with you to keep an eye on you?
No one's watching us.
Do you even do a psych ward? Do you take medication?
That's it. We are not like that. Please stop asking these questions and just let it be.
We have a lot of ANPs, so we have a lot of apparently normal parts, which makes my life a lot easier. So for my system, I have 5 alters. One is including me, because I'm technically still considered
this guy.
Not one alter had ever harmed him or done anything to, you know, upset anyone. It's just that terrible stereotype, and it really needs to stop. I mean, at the moment, the statistics are generally on what paper you read.
David, I just wanted to say sorry about yesterday, all the prying. I just didn't know how to react and stupid, I'm sorry.
It's okay. It's fine.
So, can the other people hear me?
Not always. Sometimes, if they choose to. But we usually come to a compromise.
It's kind of weird hearing you say we.
Me and the others are just used to saying that. We've been along around the same people for so long. It's only natural that we say we. It's also, we're all in the same body, so when we talk, it's a group thing.
So I was reading all the articles that you sent me, and I was wondering, because I saw a lot of it was caused by childhood trauma. So, I'm wondering if it's okay. What happened with you?
I was abused when I was little. Physically, pain and all of it.
It's okay, it's alright. Just breathe. You'll be okay.
Well, it was a weekend, and Mom let us out early. She went shopping, so we went out with friends. We were bored, so we started playing games, but those were boring too. And then we saw this old house. But they were too scared to go in, so they dared me to go in, and their work.
It's okay. It's alright. Just breathe.
That's it. No more of this. Lily should never have to talk about this.
Okay.
Right. We're okay. Alright, we met twice now. I suppose we're due for an intro. An introduction. My name's Joshua.
Sorry, what, Diego, what just happened?
Oh, no, don't worry about that. That was totally no one's blame. That is just what we're dealing with.
I'm so sorry, I didn't mean to trigger anything. I feel like a jerk. When you got really mad at me for making the other one talk, Lily, I think.
Spot on. Yeah, and the one who interrupted you, that was Arthur. He's the protector in our system. Usually Arthur comes out when David's confronted verbally, and he's usually calm about it, but Arthur has a soft spot for Lily. So when Lily comes out, he watches intently.
I think I met him in the study room. It's a lot more calm then. Why is he so protective of Lily?
According to Dr. Nash, Lily is a memory holder in our system, which means that she embodies a certain period of David's life.
So just by looking at her, I'm guessing she's the embodiment of whatever trauma happened?
Lily emerged around the same time that David fell into that flooded cellar. And so you're right to assume that she does embody the trauma. Arthur came not too long after, and Dr. Nash assumed that he was just an addition to the lockup on the trauma. But he also acts as a protector. So Dr. Nash is not quite sure how Arthur came about.
Okay, so Lily is the memory holder, right? And she holds on to all the traumatic memories from the past.
Well, not all memory holders do. It's sometimes they hold the good memories, and they keeps up the system's morale. It's just that this time, it was the trauma that was being compartmentalized.
Okay, so basically Arthur's the protector for you all. And he comes out whenever you guys are feeling really bad about something, especially when Lily feels bad about remembering things.
In a sense, yes. I wouldn't put it like that, but as long as you're understanding it, I appreciate it.
So, who are you?
I'm Joshua.
I know that, but like, what do you do?
Right. I'm an interject. Which means I'm based on an actual person David met. A good man, I hear. And David had many good memories with him. So I've just taken on the role as him inside of David, keeping him calm, making sure things run smoothly.
Okay. Is there any chance I would get to speak to David?
Yes, of course.
David?
Yes. So, I guess you've seen them.
Yeah.
I would really appreciate if you keep this in between both of us.
Yeah, of course, man. I completely understand. I wouldn't want somebody prying me either.
It means a lot, it really does.
I guess I'll see you in class tomorrow.
Alright, dude.
See you then.
Alright, see you tomorrow.